So when we look at interior gateway protocols, then we can break them into two categories. And I'll tell you right up front, I am not a fan of these categories at all. In order to properly study the Cisco information and Cisco curriculum, you really do need to understand the difference between distance vector and link state routing protocols. In practice and industry, you apply these a little bit differently because you apply the routing protocols based on the needs of your environment, and you worry less about the category they're in, and at this point in time, we worry more about the features they have to offer us. The terms distance vector and link state are kind of ancient in the sense of data networking, and the protocols that we use don't always fall into the exact category of distance vector or link state. And I'll explain that here. So distance vector routing protocols are the oldest version of routing protocols. They're very inefficient and they're very slow. And what they do is they advertise the routing table periodically. So every so often, it'll take everything in the entire routing table and send it out to all the other routers that it's connected to. In the case of routing information protocol, or RIP, which is one of our examples of a distance vector routing protocol, every 30 seconds, it will send out the entire routing table to its neighbors, whether it needs to or not. Every 30 seconds, it's going, here's my routing table, here's my routing table, here's my routing table, here's my routing table. The advertisements that it sends out, these routing table advertisements that it sends out, contain a distance or a metric. In the case of RIP, it's hop count, or the number of routers that that particular route has to traverse, or the number of routers that that particular packet destined for a network would have to traverse in order to reach its destination. All right, so hop count is an incredibly inefficient mechanism as well for metric, as we'll see in a moment. Routers record the interface that the route is received on. All right, so the routers are going to be paying attention to the interfaces that they receive the routers on, and the routers do not advertise networks out the interface on which they were received. This is called split horizon. So if Fast Ethernet 0.0 of a router received a routing update from its neighbor for network 10.0.0.0/24, a distance vector routing protocol would not advertise network 10.0.0.0/24 out interface Fast Ethernet 0.0. because that network was received on that interface. Now, in the case of routing information protocol, we use a little bit different procedure for that, and in RIP, we do something called split horizon with poison reverse. Wow, that sounds awful, doesn't it? And what that means is that if we receive network 10.0.0.0/24 on Fast Ethernet 0/1, what we do is we actually do send an advertisement for network 10.0.0.0/24 back out Fast Ethernet 0.1, except we poison it. We poison it with a metric that's unusable for RIP, so that when the other router receives it, it throws it away. So we have split horizon, which means do not advertise networks out the interface they were received on. And then we have split horizon with poison reverse, which means that we will advertise that network out the interface it was received on. We just poison it and make it useless so that when the other router gets it, it throws it away. Some examples then of distance vector routing, we have RIP. RIP is probably one of the older routing protocols that's still around today. As a matter of fact, if you have a Linksys router or D-Link router or some type of small business home office type router in your home, which you most likely do, chances are it supports RIP, and you can use routing information protocol on it to exchange information. RIP is a very slow routing protocol. It can take 30 seconds to several minutes to converge, so your network could be down for a long time before it starts passing traffic again. It's also inefficient in that it is a class full routing protocol in many ways. Class full routing protocols do some goofy things with networks that can make routing very complicated and actually break your routing protocol. Cisco came up quite a long time ago with a protocol called Interior Gateway Routing Protocol that was a proprietary version of RIP, just implemented a little bit differently. It was a distance vector routing protocol. Cisco has since deprecated that and came out with Enhanced Interior Gateway Routing Protocol, or EIGRP. And this is considered an advanced distance vector protocol because most of the characteristics of a distance vector routing protocol don't actually fit with EIGRP. EIGRP, I actually have a lot of respect for. It's a great protocol. Cisco just recently made it open source by publishing it as an RFC so that other people can implement it into their equipment. Whether or not that will happen is unknown. I suspect that was a marketing venture for Cisco to get companies that they will purchase in the future to include EIGRP into their products before Cisco buys them. But that's a separate conversation about how Cisco does business. At any rate, EIGRP is a very solid routing protocol, and it operates very efficiently, very quickly, and does not necessarily have all the characteristics of a distance vector routing protocol. Cisco will tell you, though, that it is an advanced distance vector protocol. Do you need to know that it's an advanced distance vector routing protocol in the real world? No. You need to know that EIGRP is an outstanding routing protocol, and you need to know how it operates, more so than you need to know what type it is.